this time, please.
Consonant, please.
R.
Consonant.
Another consonant, S.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
P.
Consonant.
T.
Vowel.
And A.
Consonant.
G.
Vowel.
A vowel, which is O. One last one.
And another vowel.
Thank you very much. That's you.
Right, here's the clock. There, John?
Six.
Six. And Tim?
Seven.
Seven. Right, let's go with the six, John.
Groups.
Groups. And the seven?
Agoutis.
What was that?
Agoutis.
Agoutis.
A-G-O-U-T-I-S. Yes.
Fantastic. Yep. Comes up quite often, actually, on Countdown, doesn't it? They're large, long-legged, burrowing rodents, and they look very much like huge guinea pigs.
Really?
Yeah. Well done.
And what have you got in the corner?
Well, we've got one other seven. Guitars.
Guitars. Mm. Oh, you're very musical all of a sudden here.
Oh, well, yeah. Try.
Right, let's see what Tim can do with the next set of letters.
Consonant.
Consonant, Tim. R.
Consonant.
Q.
Vowel.
I.
Vowel.
A.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
M.
Consonant.
F.
Vowel.
And a vowel, Tim. I.
And one more clock. Eyes. I don't know what we're going to do. Tim?
Only four.
Only four this time. I'm not surprised. John?
And only four.
And only four. Let's have Tim's four.
Farm.
Farm. And John?
Fair.
Fair. Firm. Farm. Firm. Verb. What have you got over there?
Yeah, same. Trim. You know, there's quite a lot of them, isn't there?
It's but, all the three I's. It's not, you don't very often see three vowels appear on the board there.
No.
Makes really nothing. No E.
Right. 57, playing 11. Susie's origins of words and phrases. What words you got today, Susie?
Yeah, we've been looking at words that appear to be completely separate and distinct from each other, but which are in fact linked. And another couple is assassin. And assassin and hashish. So you wouldn't think those two were related at all. And slang, through centuries and centuries and centuries, has always focused really on the three main themes, really, which is sex, alcohol, and music. But there's a fourth one which is definitely coming up now and which has been sort of simmering below the surface for a while, and it's drugs. And in 1300 there were armed thugs in Turkey who often hired themselves out as hitmen, basically as hired murderers. And either to boost their courage or to forget the fact that what they were about to do was very dastardly, or just have a good time, they would sit in groups and smoke hashish. They would smoke hash. At that time, these people, these hired assassins, became known for their drug of choice, and they were known as hashashins. Hashashins. And very slowly, in the way that, you know, English does sort of corrupt a sound, because it's like, a bit like Chinese whispers, it's passed on, it became assassins.
Oh.
And so, yeah, so it goes all the way back to their drugs, I'm afraid.
Things doesn't seem to have changed much in the last 700 years.
Probably not.
Right, we're going to go to the numbers board, and John, you're going to call them out for Carol.
One large,
yep.
And any five small.
And five small, the classic selection. Once again on Countdown today, we have then, gentlemen, 4, 10 and 8. 1, 9 and 50. And the target... $500.
Here's a clock. Right, 500. Anybody got that?
Yes.
What about you, Tim?
Yes.
Yes, and you, John? I don't think we need even check it out. And how about you? Would you have got that, Nicholas?
I'm still struggling.
You're working. Well, never mind. We'll give you a little bit of help.
How I did it.
You did it. Oh, well, I was betting that you would. Okay, well, we'll give them the points anyway, because I'm sure that... Right, 10 points each for the gentleman there. And we go to a tea time teaser now. And the word is gash band. Gash band. And the clue, a tame brawl for the ladies, perhaps. A tame brawl for the ladies, perhaps. That word was gash band, and the clue, a tame brawl for the ladies, perhaps. And the answer?
Handbags.
Oh. Handbags.
Handbags at dawn. That's right. Yeah. I was just thinking, you know, because I loved Susie's explanation earlier about the association between hashish and assassin, but I was wondering, you know, when you said the attempted assassination of, for instance, Pope John Paul II and obviously President Reagan and so on, when is somebody important enough to have been assassinated rather than murdered?
I don't know. I think it's just a position there. If it's a political or a religious...
I don't know. What about our news anchor? Because you
You're right, Des. It's the definition is an important person, but of course we've all got ideas who that might be.
Yeah.
But it's political or religious motives. Yeah. So if you think about it, Benazir Bhutto recently, of course, is assassinated.
Yeah.
Everybody else is murdered.
Okey-doke. Well, on that sober thought, we'll move on and we'll start again with Tim's choice of letters.
Consonant.
Consonant. J.
Consonant.
L.
Consonant.
D.
Vowel.
U.
Vowel.
E.
Vowel.
A.
Consonant.
N.
Consonant.
M.
Vowel.
And O.
And one more clock. What do you have, Tim?
Six.
Six. John?
Five.
Five. Let's have the five.
Mould.
Mould?
M-O-U-L-D.
M-O-U-L-D. And Tim?
Module.
Module.
Very
yep.
Mm.
That's
very
six
good,
yeah. There. And in the corner, they're difficult today, aren't they?
They are.
They're doing terribly well. Yeah, we could another six. Demon, if you spell it and put the A, as we were talking a couple of days ago on this programme, haven't we, about that?
Yes, archaic spelling, or indeed computer spelling now.
Okay, the score is 73, playing 2-1. John, your choice of letters, please.